In navigation, the word strategy just means the methods that you're going to use to get from somewhere to somewhere else. And almost always, there isn't just one method used, but rather there's a mixture and a combination that you can use to make sure that you get where you want to go. Also, it's normal to use different strategies for all different parts of the walk. And the strategies that you use will depend on your ability, the weather, the terrain, the visibility, the group that you're walking with, and the equipment that you've got, or the time of day, and lots of other factors. I've just finished teaching on an advanced navigation exercise, and as the participants were leaving, they told me that they'd really enjoyed it, and to show their appreciation, they'd bought me a gift, which was awfully nice of them. But all they gave me was a copy of a 200-year-old map of this area, with a grid reference, a 10-figure grid reference written on the back of it, which is SD87624-64805. So today I'm looking for a very specific 1 meter square of grass in the middle of a big field. And the only way that I'll be able to do this is to come up with a strategy which will get me there. Now, looking at my map, this 1 meter square seems to be on, basically it's on an east sloping hill. In that direction. Now, I do like a challenge, but I thought I'd ask you, how would you go about this? I'll put the map on the screen so you can come up with some ideas. My current position is shown on the map and also the destination. How would you get there? As an example, would you just set off and keep walking until you arrive, or would you break the journey down into separate legs? Oh, a leg in navigation is a section of an overall walk or route. Which skills do you think you'll need along that route? Do you have those skills? And also, most importantly, are you confident that you can use them in these conditions over this terrain? The weather today isn't bad, as you can see. It's about 50 meter visibility and we've got plenty of time. Have you got the correct equipment? So pause the video and try and come up with some methods or strategies for getting from the start to the destination. Give yourself a few minutes to look at the map and then I'll come back to you. Have you worked out your strategy? For the first leg, the plan is simple. Follow the track for the first 700 meters until we hit a field boundary. And around here in this area, that usually means a dry stone wall. Don't forget, strategies really don't need to be complicated. In fact, the simpler something is, the less likely it is to go wrong. As an example, in this case, I know that I'm stood on a road and I know that I need to walk away from the road. And the question is, do I go that way or do I go that way? If I start walking down there, the wall will be on my left-hand side, but the map is showing me that the wall should be on my right-hand side. A wall on a map is a continuous black line. Now, I could take out a compass and take a compass bearing and follow that. But as always, the best option is, it's normally just to use the simplest thing you can that will work in your situation. And in this case, I would suggest that just orienting my map to the terrain, and by doing this, I can see that that's my direction, because when I walk up there, that wall will be on my right-hand side. That's better. Now there's a wall on my right-hand side, which is where it should be. And I can see that the track will bear away slightly to the left, away from the wall. So this gives me confidence that that's my direction, that's the way I should be going. I can use Naismith's rule to work out the timings for this part of the route up to the track wall junction. So it's around 700 meters with a 50 meter rise. So that's what, at 5 kilometers an hour, that's 8.5 minutes for the walk and another 5 minutes for the ascent. So we'll call it just under a quarter of an hour. And that should get us up there. Right, let's go. As I'm walking up, I'm looking for ground features that I've identified on the map. Well, it's a sort of mental tick list. So as I go past them, I just tick them off mentally. And this just confirms that I'm going in the right direction. The map shows me this track should curve round back round to the right, and then it will start running parallel to the wall just before the junction. nowhere is this track actually straight. So if I start walking in a straight line for 50 or 100 meters, then I'll know I've gone too far. So on the map, it shows that there's a small feature on the right-hand side as I get to the wall track junction. It looks to be, I'm guessing here, it's an old sheep pen or something like that. It looks too small to be anything to do with cows. We'll go up and have a look and explore and see what it is. So this is the feature that I was expecting. I'm not actually sure what it is. It looks like an old sheep pen. It's too small for cows. I actually don't know what it is. Some sort of building. I've just seen a family walking down the track, and they were, as Alfred Wainwright would put it, they were inappropriately dressed for the conditions. We had mist earlier on, but now we've got fog. The difference is, by the way, if there's limited visibility due to water in the atmosphere, then if you can see more than a kilometer, then it's mist. If you can see less than a kilometer, then it's fog. Simple as that. It is quite cold today. My nose thermometer tells me that, you know what I mean, nose thermometer, tells me that it's below freezing. And the family that just walked down, they weren't dressed for these conditions, this temperature. And especially the wife and one of the kids, their SHG, Sierra Hotel Golf, had it frozen up. An SHG, by the way, I've got a first aid kit, so I'm almost a fully qualified medical doctor. As long as you want a triangular bandage, I'm good at those. Anything else? Well, we'll see. Anyway, SHG is people who go walking in the hills regularly, they're used to, especially in England and Scotland on the Cairngorms, they're used to the wind coming straight at them in their face. They're used to driving rain and horrible conditions and just not nice. But, you know, well, behind your top lip here, there's a gland. You see, I told you I was almost a doctor. There's a gland behind here called the SHG. And this gland is called, it's actually, the technical name is the sense of humor gland. And what happens is when people who aren't used to being out in the hills, when the wind and the rain and the cold start, their sense of humor gland dries up and it makes their face do this. They're not happy. Whereas people who go walking in the hills regularly, their sense of humor gland never dries up and they're always smiling, regardless of the conditions. I almost started to waffle then. If I start to waffle, just shout at the screen, shut up and get on with the video. I shall do. Using my oriented map, I can see that from here the terrain rises to the west-southwest. And I can also just make out in the fog behind me the slope as it goes up. That's where my gift is, at the top of that hill. Now, there are a number of ways that I could get nearer to the location. I could just follow the same wall for another 600 meters until I get to a gate. I know there will be a gate because there the track goes through a wall. At that point, I'll turn left to another junction, and then after about 180 meters, I'll get to the start of some limestone pavement. Or I could follow this track that goes off to the southwest for 400 meters and then turn right towards the northwest. But in that area, I can see a shake hole on the map. And where there's one, there's always more. If you have a choice, it's never really a good idea to walk in an area with shake holes, especially when you're on your own. So in this case, there's a few ways that I can get up there. But following walls, it seems to be quite a long way. So I think I'll just walk literally almost straight up the slope until I get near to where I'm going. And from there, we'll sort something out. So from here, I'm going to go to the Anglo-Saxon remains. It's an old Anglo-Saxon building. And it is 250 meters on a bearing of 263. How absolutely amazing is this? An Anglo-Saxon homestead. Hopefully you can make it out on the on your screen. I'll walk around it, the shape of it. Absolutely amazing. The Anglo-Saxons arrived just after the Romans left. So 1,500 years ago, a family and their animals were living in that. I just find it absolutely amazing. Hopefully you do. The temperature's continuing to drop, so I think it's time for a put my hat on. On the map, I can see a line of rocks and I can also make them out on the ground. And I really don't want to try and climb over those. I'm out here on my own. And if I slipped and fell, it would be problematical. So I think I'll go to the left of the outcrop. As the contour lines there are thinner together, it will be a little bit steeper. But I do think that's the safer route. Always safety first. At the top of the rise is a large flat area just going up a gentle slope upwards towards the west. And once I arrive on that flatter area, I'll look around for something that I can identify on the ground and also on the map, and that'll tell me exactly where I am. But first, time for tea and sandwiches, I think. Oh, the sandwiches today, by the way. Hopefully you can see these from, I'll bring it over. What we've got is sliced pork medallion and mushrooms and a Bramley apple sauce. Come on. As I say, there is no excuse for going up the hills with a lazy sandwich. I'll have my tea first. I've just got to the top of the rise and I'm onto the flatter area. And it looks at first glance just to be a wide open expanse of grass. This is why they put my gift up here. Maybe they're testing me. But there's always something. Let's have a look. What have we got? So, I've got it. I've worked it out. Let me just check it with my compass. That was north, that was east. Perfect. Let me turn the camera around. And this is it. Can you see it behind me? What, as I said, it may at first appear to just be a massive expanse of grass, but it's not. If you look behind me, the ground there is going downhill in that direction. But here, the ground is going down in that direction. I'll bring the camera over so you can see it on the compass. That is going due north. And that bit of ground there is going due east. And this bit of ground between me and the camera is going down that direction. So there is a definite, and then it goes that way. And I really should plan these videos and I wouldn't have to start finding this sort of stuff when I arrive. that'd be a little bit too professional for me. Just get a camera, go up the hill and chat. So here we go. On the map, there is a definite right angle contour very, very near to the location of my gift. I imagine, well, I'm hoping they realized that and that's why they did it. Otherwise, it wasn't a very advanced navigation exercise, was it, that they were on? That's a different conversation. So anyway, we now know exactly where we are. We are on this contour line. Now, what I could do, if the conditions were better, I can actually just make out the gate with a little sheep pen over there. And there's another gate over there. So I could actually do a resection and start drawing lines on my map. But this is a lot easier. Just use the slope aspect. The slope aspect is the direction that it slopes downhill. As I said, that's north, that's east. This is straight down there. So this is the corner of that contour line. So we're almost there. 246 degrees, 54 and a half paces, and we'll set the watch to make sure we don't walk too far. Here we go. Let's just get this. Oh, I don't know. Off we go then. Set the watch. One, two, three, four, 5. I can see the gift. Absolutely perfect. What? Amazing. Just what I wanted. So, which were the strategies that we used today? Well, to start with, we used an oriented map to make sure that we were going in the right direction along the track. That was the first strategy. Then, as we were walking along, we used collecting and catching features. If you remember, we were expecting the track to curve around to the right slightly, and also then to run parallel. We're also making sure that the track didn't go forwards a few hundred meters, so we'd missed our target. We also used Naismith's rule to work out how long that leg should take. Next, we used feature recognition or terrain association, as we were able to recognize the shape of the terrain from the details on the map. What was the next one? Oh yeah, then we used contour interpretation, so we could tell what the route was going to be like, how steep. And at the top of the rise, we used aspect, slope aspect, or the direction. And that told us our exact location. And for the final section, we followed a compass bearing, as well as using pacing and timing. So orientation, collecting features, catching features, terrain association, contour interpretation, slope aspect, pacing, timing, and following a compass bearing. There you go. So just in this very short route that we've done today, we used 9 really simple strategies, and we didn't need to use anything complicated. I would guess that most people who go out walking in the hills would have no problems when using any of these techniques, even if they don't know what they're called. But if you're not quite sure about anything that we've done today, I've made separate videos going into much more detail on each of these 9 skills. So hopefully you'll have a better idea of what navigation strategies are now, and also how to combine them when you're walking to something or somewhere which isn't really well marked or identified on a map. What was the gift that the group gave me? There you go. How can I describe this? Well, let's put it this way. In Britain, we have some things which people in other countries might find strange. As an example, every December we have Colin the Caterpillar. Most people never buy one, but we all know what they are. We have chip butties. We're obsessed by the weather. We argue about whether it's pronounced scone or scone. We say sorry all the time, even when we're not sorry. And some people nearly kill themselves every year chasing a lump of cheese rolling down a very steep hill. And if they're still alive, they'll do it again next year, etc., etc. But one of the things which I'm most proud of personally are Bassett's jelly babies. I know there are other companies who try to make them, but imitations. But in England, they have to be Bassett's. They are absolutely amazing. Hopefully you now have a better idea of what navigation strategies are and how to combine them. So, you know, when you're walking out in the hills, you can think, shall I use an oriented map? Shall I follow a compass bearing? Can I recognize that slope from what's on the map? You know, that sort of thing. So combine all the strategies and you'll have a wonderful day out in the hills. Thanks for watching.